Hello world, I'm Imagination. Today I'm going to talk about Google's new chatbot, which is capable of near-human conversation. A chatbot is a software application used to conduct an online chat conversation via text or text-to-speech, in lieu of providing direct contact with a live human agent. Designed to convincingly simulate the way a human would behave as a conversational partner, chatbot systems typically require continuous tuning and testing, and many in production remain unable to adequately converse or pass the industry standard Turing test. The term ChatterBot was originally coined by Michael Mauldin, creator of the first Verbot, in 1994 to describe these conversational programs. Chatbots are typically used in dialog systems for various purposes including customer service, request routing, or for information gathering. While some chatbot applications use extensive word classification processes, natural language processors, and sophisticated AI, others simply scan for general keywords and generate responses using common phrases obtained from an associated library or database. Today, most chatbots are accessed online via website pop-ups, or through virtual assistants such as Google Assistant, Amazon Alexa, or messaging apps such as Facebook Messenger or WeChat. Chatbots are typically classified into usage categories that include commerce, e-commerce via chat, education, entertainment, finance, health, news, and productivity. Google has released a neural network-powered chatbot called Mina that it claims is better than any other chatbot out there. Mina was trained on a whopping 341 gigabytes of public social media chatter, 8.5 times as much data as OpenAI's GPT-2. Google says Mina can talk about pretty much anything, and can even make up an open-ended conversation that covers a wide range of topics is hard, and most chatbots can't keep up. At some point, most say things that make no sense or reveal a lack of basic knowledge about the world. A chatbot that avoids such mistakes will go a long way toward making AIs feel more human and make characters in video games more lifelike. To put Mina to the test, Google has developed a new metric it calls the Sensibleness and Specificity Average, SA, which captures important attributes for natural conversations, such as whether each utterance makes sense in context, which many chatbots can do, and is specific to what has just been said, which is harder. For example, if you say "I like tennis" and a chatbot replies "that's nice," the response makes sense but is not specific. Many chatbots rely on tricks like this to hide the fact that they don't know what you're talking about. On the other hand, a response such as "me too, I can't get enough of Roger Federer" is specific. Google used crowd workers to generate sample conversations and to score utterances in around 100 conversations. Mina got a score of 79%, compared with 56% for Miku, a state-of-the-art chatbot that has won the Leibniz Prize for the last 4 years. Even human conversation partners only scored 86% in this new test. Our intelligence is what makes us human, and AI is an extension of that quality. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.